Hi everyone, I am Pratima. In my last videos, we discussed the introduction regarding physiology of endocrine system, and again, next we discussed the structure and function of hypothalamus, structure and function of pituitary, and the relationship between the hypothalamus and pituitary. Those concepts we already studied in detail. Today, I enter into the new concept, that is physiology of thyroid gland. Physiology is nothing but we need to study the structure and hormones and their functions which are secreted from the thyroid gland. Okay, as you all know that thyroid gland is also one of the major endocrine gland what we observed in case of the human. And structurally, this thyroid gland is located on either side of the trachea by means of a two lateral lobes. Okay, thyroid gland is located on either side of the trachea by means of two lateral lobes, and these two lateral lobes are interconnected by means of a muscular projection. That is known as isthmus. Okay, and behind this thyroid gland, each lobe encloses or possesses a pair of small glands. Those are called parathyroid gland. Okay, on each lobe we observe the presence of pair of parathyroid gland behind the thyroid gland. So in thyroid gland we observe the two pair of parathyroid gland or four parathyroid gland on each lobe, two or on each lobe one pair behind the thyroid gland. This is the morphological view or morphological observation, or morphologically we can see the thyroid gland like this. Okay, then if we consider the TS of the thyroid gland or anatomical view of the thyroid gland, this thyroid gland is made up of number of circular follicles, and those follicles are named as thyroid follicles. Okay, anatomically this thyroid gland is made up of number of circular follicles, and those follicles are named as thyroid follicles. These thyroid follicles are lined by means of a simple cuboidal epithelial cell or simple cuboidal epithelial tissue. Each follicles are lined by means of a simple cuboidal epithelial tissue or simple cuboidal epithelial cells. And again, each follicle encloses a large cavity inside the follicle or large lumen like structure, that is known as a lumen, and it is filled with the rich proteinaceous substance, that is known as colloid. Okay, structurally thyroid gland is made up of number of circular follicles. Those follicles are known as thyroid follicles, and this thyroid follicle or each thyroid follicles are lined by means of a simple cuboidal epithelial tissue or simple cuboidal epithelial cells. And again, each follicle encloses a large cavity in the middle, that is known as lumen. And this lumen is filled with a highly or rich proteinaceous substance, that is known as colloid. This is the structure of the thyroid gland. And again, these follicles or thyroid follicles, internally or in between these thyroid follicle we observe some special cells. Those cells are known as C cells or parafollicular cells. Para means side, or beside the follicles we observe another kind of cells. Those are known as parafollicular cells or C cells. Again, we can observe this connective tissue, blood, those things are in between the follicles. This is the anatomical or TS of the thyroid gland. Then, what are the different hormones which are going to secreted from thyroid gland, and what is the function of each hormone we need to know. Here, mainly this thyroid gland is responsible for production of three major hormones. And again, this thyroid follicles are capable of producing two major hormones. Those are T3 and T4. T3 is nothing but triiodothyronine. T4 is commonly called as thyroxine, and it is also called as tetraiodothyronine. These are the two major hormones secreted from the thyroid follicles by the stimulus of thyroid stimulating hormone from anterior part of the pituitary. Okay, major hormones are thyroid gland in the secrete of the T3 and T4. These are the two major hormones, triiodothyronine and thyroxine, or you can call it as a tetraiodothyronine from the thyroid follicle. Again, these interstitial cells are the cells which are present in between these thyroid follicles are known as parafollicular cells. These parafollicular cells are also responsible for production of one more hormone, that is calcitonin. What? Calcitonin. These are the three major hormones which are secreted from the thyroid gland. And I already told that each thyroid lobe or thyroid lobe enclosed with a pair of parathyroid glands behind it. Those pair of parathyroid glands are also capable of producing one more hormone, that is parathormone or parathormone. Okay, we observe four different kinds of hormones. If we consider a thyroid, there are three major hormones which are secreted from the thyroid. What are those? T3, T4 and calcitonin. Again, the calcitonin is the secretion of parafollicular cells present in case of the thyroid gland. But these three, T3 and T4, are the major two hormones secreted from the thyroid follicles of the thyroid gland. And again, parathormone is one of the hormone which is secreted from the small glands which are situated behind the thyroid gland, called parathyroid glands. Now we need to know the functions which are controlled or which are acted by these four different hormones of the thyroid and parathyroid gland. If we consider T3 and T4, these two hormones are responsible for maintaining the high metabolic rate in the human body. And again, these T3 and T4 are named as thermogenic hormones. So they are responsible for maintaining the temperature in the body of an organism. Usually, these T3 and T4 are responsible for increasing the body temperature of an organism. If we consider the developmental process of an organism, these T3 and T4 are responsible for development of a nervous system of an organism. And again, if we consider some lower organism, we observe the indirect development, in that we observe process of metamorphosis. In that metamorphosis process, these two hormones play a vital role for the development of an organism. And rather than these two hormones, these calcitonin and parathormone, here I need to say one point is, these calcitonin and parathormones do not secreted from the stimulus, do not secreted by the stimulus of TSH. We know that TSH is the thyroid stimulating hormone secreted from the adenohypophysis of the pituitary and give the stimulus to the thyroid gland to produce T3 and T4 hormones. But these calcitonin and parathormones are secreted due to the concentration level of calcium ion in the blood. Okay, so calcitonin is going to secreted when higher concentration of calcium occur in case of blood by parafollicular cell. And again, this parathormone is secreted or produced only when we observe the low concentration or deficiency in the calcium level of the blood by the parathyroid gland. Okay, that's why these two hormones are considered as antagonistic hormones. They are produced from the antagonistic or opposite stimuli of the body, as well as they are produced and work against to each other. That's why they are known as or named as antagonistic hormone. Now, clear the calcitonin eva produce apathy. If we observe the high level of calcium ion concentration in blood, that is give the stimulus to the parafollicular cell of thyroid gland to secrete the calcitonin hormone, and the secretion of this calcitonin is responsible. What is the work it is going to do is, it is going to regulate or decreases the concentration of calcium ion into the normal level. Okay, high concentration of calcium level aadaga athwa normal level igina calcium concentration level jaasti aadaga blood alli, and that time this calcitonin is going to secreted from the parafollicular cell of the thyroid, and it is responsible to reduce the calcium level into the normal condition. Similarly, this parathormone is secreted when the calcium level is low compared to the normal level from the parathyroid gland. So what it do is, it is going to stimulate or increases the calcium level from lower concentration to the normal level of the calcium ion concentration in the blood. That's why these two hormones, calcitonin and parathormones, responsible for maintaining the homeostasis in the calcium level of the blood. Maintaining the homeostasis of the calcium level in the blood. So these are the different hormones and their respective function from the thyroid and parathyroid gland.